Hello everyone. Today I am going to talk on a very important topic, that is subject verb concord. In this short video, I will talk on what is meant by subject, what is meant by verb, the grammatical agreement between subject and verb, and also the markers that show the agreement between subject and verb. I hope you will enjoy this lecture. Before we turn to the relationship between subject and verb, it is important to know different parts of the clause or a sentence. Verb and subject are the important parts of a clause. There are several definitions of these words, but here are the common analysis, common understanding of these words. Subject is the noun or noun phrase or noun clause that comes before the verb, and it answers the questions like who or what. And here you should remember that it always occurs before the verb, and in a statement it comes in the beginning of the sentence or in the first position. And the word verb is a word that indicates an action, event, or state. It occurs after the subject. It indicates the main action in the sentence. Here are two examples. First is Jean loves Mary, and second is the pictures look beautiful. Now in the first example, Jean is the subject and loves is the verb. Now if you see the subject Jean, it is in third person singular form. Therefore the suffix s is added to the main verb. So it is not love, but it is loves. So Jean loves Mary. It is not found in the second example. The second example is the pictures look beautiful. Now here the pictures is the subject and look is the main verb. And here the main verb is without any suffix. It's only look without any s or es suffix. Because if you see the subject, it is in plural form, and therefore S or ES is not added to it. So the pictures look beautiful. So if you see the subjects and the verbs in both the examples, you could find that there is a relationship between subject and verb. And this relationship is very important in the subject-verb concord. We shall remember that the verb of a sentence decides what kind of a subject it would allow. So if you see the subject and verb, you could find a grammatical relationship or the grammatical agreement between the subject and the verb. And this kind of a relationship is clearly seen when the subject is third person and singular or plural. So there are very particular specific markers we could see in the verb of the sentence. Look at the examples below. First example is Ravi teaches English. Second is he teaches English. And the third is Ravi and Vijay teach English. Now in all the three examples, the verb is common. In the first example it is teaches, in the second also it is teaches, and in the third example, in the third sentence, it is teach. So if you see why it has changed in the third example, you must look at the subject. In the first sentence, Ravi is the subject, and if you see the subject Ravi, it is third person singular. And therefore suffix s is added to the main verb. So teach is the main verb and suffix es is added to the main verb. So it is Ravi teaches English. The same about the example number second. He teaches English. Now here he is the subject and teach is the main verb. But if you see subject, it is again third person and also it is singular. And therefore, suffix es is added to the main verb. So it's a he teaches English. But it is not found in the third example. Ravi and Vijay teach English. Now here, if you see the subject, it is Ravi and Vijay. So it is third person, but it is not singular. It is plural. And therefore, not suffix like s or es is added to the main verb. And therefore, it is only teach. So Ravi and Vijay teach English. So if you see how subject, it influence the verb. It decides the form of a verb. And this kind of a reflection of the subject on the verb is very important in the subject verb concord. And this phenomena is called subject verb concord. In English, there is a relationship between subject and verb. And this concord or agreement is physically seen when the subject is third person and singular. But if the subject is singular and it is not in third person, the verb does not change. For example, if the subject is I, the verb does not change. Look at the example. I like books. Now here, I is the subject and like is the verb. Now here, subject is singular, but still the verb is not changed because it is not in third person. It only changes when the subject is singular and in third person form. So here it is only singular, but not in third person. Therefore, I like books. In other languages, there are different subject verb concord markers. In English, we have a suffix like s or es. But in other languages, we may find different kinds of markers. But you know that in a language where there is a strong bond between subject and verb, the action is marked or encoded in the verb, and it is in the form of the agreement marker. So even without some subject, we can understand the action from the sentence. And this whole phenomena is called subject-verb concord. So thank you very much for watching it. I hope you would have enjoyed it. Have a great time. Thank you.